Aki Kareem for British Boxers. We're here with Robert Rimmer, trained with Charlie Schofield. Charlie just victorious there again, moves to, is it 10-0 now?
11-0.
Curtis Gargano. Talk us through the fight, Robert, from your point of view.
Do you know what, listen, it's been a frustrating week really, because we had an opponent, which was a worthy opponent beforehand. I was looking forward to going into it, it was going to be a bigger test for Charlie this time around. Anyway, the opponent somehow failed the brain scan, so last minute, obviously we got Curtis, so obviously we had fought Curtis in the last fight. So going into this fight, we knew what we expected of Curtis. So I said to Charlie, I said, look, you know, he's not the biggest of punchers, but his work rate's fantastic. So this time round, I wanted him to put shots together a little bit more, instead of them single pot shots, threes and fours, and basically just change gear throughout the rounds and improving his last performance, which I think he did overall. I actually do think he did, but there was times in the fight where I think he showed a little bit too much respect and he reverted back to them little pot shot, single shots, trying to load up and catch Curtis. You're never going to stop that guy, you know, with big shots. Unless you are a banger, then maybe. But, you know, he's tough as all boots. But overall, as a performance, I am happy.
I mean, I was actually going to ask you, you felt that Charlie improved on his last performance, and he did really, didn't he? So,
yeah.
From a trainer's point of view, is that just, are you just happy as long as each fight's a progression and a learning curve?
100%, yeah. Listen, it says a lot to me because then my fighters are listening. So, obviously, we have a game plan. I ask him to do certain things, and he's doing it. Sometimes he might switch off, but that's all fighters, it's expected. But, as an overall, he's improved on his last performance, and I'm happy with it. So, going to the next fight, same again, step up. Believe it's a challenge belt this time, so, you know, he knows that he's got to stay switched on. But as long as he keeps listening, he keeps learning, and he keeps showing signs in the ring that he can improve, he can go forward, then I'm happy.
Do you think that it's going to take sort of a meaningful title on the line, or like a real sort of dangerous opponent in front of him that's going to bring the best out of Charlie?
100%. Yeah. Like I said, in the gym, I see him sparring, with kids who are British level, European level, and he seems to be more switched on, and you see a better Charlie Schofield, and you see a better performance out of him. So, we know this, I believe, the better opponent, the better performance from Charlie we'll see.
Right, and I mean, I do appreciate your time. I know it's just one of these where we just sort of grabbed you backstage, but just on a final word then, what might be next for Charlie? You mentioned a challenge belt. When could we see that?
I think from what Steve was saying to me, I think we're going to be looking around the end of October. He's just told me an opponent.
Right.
I'm not allowed to say which the opponent is at the moment, but yeah, we've been given an opponent's name for a challenge belt, so same again, it's a step up, and hopefully it can be a big year for him.
Brilliant. Well, listen, thanks for your time, Robert. We're going to come down the gym soon, man, as well.
100%, get down there.
Yeah, we'll arrange it now. All right, man, Robert Rimmer, congratulations on the win tonight, and we'll catch up with you soon.
Thanks,
Aki Kareem, British Boxers, you know the score. Power.